Every week I try. Every day dozens try. Nothing.
In the distant past, the majority of my people were storytellers. Later, the minority. Then, there were only a few per generation. Now, there's only one in every generation. And I'm afraid I am the last.
I'll speak to Newt Whitebear for you. What do you want me to tell him?
Tell him my people no longer keep our oral traditions. They don't listen anymore. But I know the Norn still respect ancient stories. I want to stay here and share the legends of the Jotun.
The ring of the anvil is music to my ears.
Keep them alive.
I'll see what he says. Wait here. Feel free to share a tale to while I'm gone. Visitors here will find them entertaining.
Come back!
Oh.
Bygarth the Smith, what would you have of this season's finest slayer?
Oh, you're mighty confident for one so young. Reminds me of me after I won the great hunt. Oh, but that was a long time ago. I chose smithing over hunting, and I never regretted it. Now it's time to forge my masterpiece, a mighty weapon to break Jormag's tooth.
Nothing has so much as scratched the tooth in over 100 years. What makes you think you could craft such a thing?
Deldramore steel. If I can get my hands on enough of it, I can make a weapon to shatter mountains. The secret of the alloy was lost with the dwarves, but I can smelt existing relics into the steel I need. Such artifacts have surfaced in a Jotun cave near Grollenfjord. Yeah, that's why I sent for you. If you can beat back the Jotun and collect the artifacts I need to forge the weapon, you might be worthy of bearing it. Interested?
Interested? Ha! I'm determined. Ready your forge for dwarven metal, Smithy.
Everyone for themselves. Come on now, I'm thirsty.
I enjoy.
Maybe it wasn't always like
I enjoy that there's so many references, maybe. Very subtle references to the first game. With the time of the dwarves. In the first game, you play with the dwarves, and you see their end. You're part of it, actually. So, it's cool to see that. And, okay. Don't really want to walk, so let's pay to travel a bit. So we will use the staff until we can grab some daggers. I'll probably find some soon, hopefully. Overpowered. I'm just in this area. In this area, they're just weak. They're supposed to be. They're only level 2s. And my level right now is 4. For all you new players, every zone you're in, it takes you to that level so you can play with your friends. So even though I'm level 40, my stats have been toned down.
Keep running!
Avenge me!
I mean, that's what I love about this game the most. Doesn't matter what level you are, what you're doing, you still level up where you are, and just play with anyone. Yes, let's enter. Why are humans in the Norn area? What are they doing here? Okay, what are you doing?
Run, insect! Leave before I tear your arms off and beat you to death with them!
What makes this game hard, if you play from scratch, is not having...
I need help! Oh. These ugly lumps mean to kill me!
No. Nothing can bring me down.
I can take care of myself from here. But there are more prisoners inside. Their sons dragged them in. And then I heard screams. Don't worry about me, help them.
So yeah, that's what makes it hard. It's not having skills or weapon types.
We will make another offering. A hunter who wandered too close. He's strong. His sacrifice will gain us power.
We could butcher an entire homestead without this dragon. Hero. This ceremony is
give
a way
of strength to reclaim our birthright. Jorna, give us strength.
Accept this offering with blood and blood. The ours is yours.
Jorna, give us strength. In your name, we will destroy them all. We will rule this land once more. Jormag, give us strength.
Jormag, give us strength.
See, even though I'm level 40, those guys can actually kill me. And freaking Jormag, how dare you worship Jormag?
I am death incarnate.
How dare you? Taking these artifacts. I think these are dwarves from the first game. The shrine appears to be dedicated to the Elder Dragon Jormag. Jerk. The one that took away the Eye of the North from me. A recently deceased Norn is slayed across the altar. Yes, pay respects. It descends on the cave. The shrine stands ready for your eulogy. Rest now, Hunter. May the spirits of the wild guide you to your reward in the mist. Solemn words echo throughout the cave. Leave the altar. Return to Holbrook.
Our resistance may play a role in the rebalancing.
Exactly. We have to follow our instincts and let the spirits show us the best way.
Come back!
I brought your dwarven steel, blacksmith. I also saw the bodies of the other hunters you sent. Those Jotun are worshipping the Ice Dragon.
Bear's breath. I didn't know that. I'll take the steel off your hands, but I can't do anything about the Jotun. Though I do know someone who can. Do you know Erste Gulkin? Tall, beautiful, travels with a huge black wolf. She killed one of the Ice Dragon's strongest lieutenants.
Of course. She fought beside me against Isormir, and I've heard songs of her epic deeds at several moots.
She could help us. And not to be a gossip or anything. I hear she's taken quite an interest in you since the Great Hunt.
In me? Why?
To tell you the truth, I'm not sure. Perhaps you impressed her. In any case, ask her about these Jotun, and I'm sure she'll lend a hand.
Air is by far my favorite character. I'm sure if you watch many of my videos, you hear me talk about that. That I really like Air. And I do. I really do. I love all these personal stories because you get to spend time with a member of Destiny's Edge. And I really like my time with Air. And Ridlock. Ridlock's pretty cool, but I just really do like Air. Weapon of Legend.
Hold still, Garm. You know I can't carve your image properly when you're wiggling. Ugh, this stone isn't right. It'll never... What's that, Garm? Someone's coming? Very well, we'll leave this alone for now. Perhaps the next stone will be better.
It's good to see you.
It's good to see you again, Slayer. You look troubled. What's wrong?
I've been to the Jotun Caves near Grollenfjord. They're worshipping the Elder Dragon, Jormag.
Jotun are fanatical about their old ways. They wouldn't worship Jormag. Unless... What do you know about the Sons of Svanir?
I know they're the idiots who embrace the Ice Dragon as a spirit of the wild.
From what you saw, so do these Jotun. There has to be a connection. There are Sons of Svanir near Hirbat's camp. They might be involved. This is definitely worth a Slayer's attention. If you're willing, Garm and I will meet you there. Let's see if we can persuade the Sons to tell us what's going on.
That sounds perfect. Heirs to Galkin, side by side with the Slayer of Isormir. The Skalds will sing of this for generations.
Careful. Skalds also sing of noble hunters dying grisly deaths. But with Wolf's help, we'll give them something better. See you there.
Best part about having all these things is just skipping all this.
I love Air's wolf, Garm. This... He looks big and mean, but he likes to lick my face whenever I see him.
Because Garm's awesome.
Then offense. What is this? A camp?
Ooh, bear's quite aggressive. I like it so far. God. Stampeding around. Disciples of the Dragon.
The Sons of Svanir are close by. We can try talking to them, but they hate anyone who doesn't serve their dragon, and they utterly despise women.
Maybe Garm should take the lead.
Bad idea. Garm leads with his teeth.
Well, well. Look, brothers. A stranger, a woman, and a mangy dog. It's like the beginning of a bad joke.
We're here about Jotun worshipping the ice dragon near Gralenfjord.
Go back to carving stones, Stegulkin, and take your dogs with you.
Seems you boys didn't understand the lady. I'll say it slower. Tell us about the Jotun and the dragon.
You should have left when you had the chance. Now you die.
He's a good diplomat.
Looks like we're doing this the hard way. Garm, with me.
Intruders! Slayer of Isormir! Kill them both!
My brothers will avenge me.
You're welcome to keep me alive.
Stay alert. There's another wave coming. That's how I do it.
I punish the weak.
I am death
digging get in. A stick
we need to go on the offensive
fight.
And take the fight to
you
them.
You washed up has-been.
All right. Very nice.
Curse you! None can desecrate the dragon's shrine and live!
Here you will find your defeat.
My brothers will avenge me.
Destroy you myself. In Jormag's name, I will kill you all.
Nothing can bring me down. I am death incarnate. Then off.
Well done. Now let's see what their meter knows.
They're worshipping this dragon. How could they?
Start talking. Tell us how you converted the Jotun, or we'll whip you through the streets of Holbrek with a lash made of Air's braids.
You wouldn't dare. I'd be slaughtered by my own comrades.
Then tell us what we want to know.
All right. We converted the giant King Korag. He converted his followers in Ozenfold Shear.
This Korag sounds ambitious. The Jotun haven't had a giant king for centuries, and the last thing Holbrek needs is one that worships Jormag.
Drag this fool to Holbrek and give him to the Wolfborn. I'll head for Ossenfold Shear and have a word with Korag, the Giant King.
Wolf's shaggy hide, you're a bold one. Be careful. There's glory in fighting impossible odds, but it's hard to brag when you're dead.
Don't worry, we'll share a drink to victory in the Great Lodge when I return.
Good hunting, Slayer. Jotun may be bigger, but you're badder.
Yes, there's the dagger that I wanted.
It's over.
Be strong.
I've made enough dried chicken feet talismans to take a load to the Haven.
You actually managed to sell those horrible things?
Ah, yes. Humans think they bring good luck, and Char use them to pick their teeth.
The promise of adventure calls us north, but it takes a fierce and wild heart to survive outside of this sacred valley. When you're ready, test yourself against the untamed spirit of Hair. If you can outlast her mettle, you may have what it takes to weather the challenges of the frontier.
Quickly!
Nice little harvest right there.
Another land to spread my legend.
Lost to take some of the things you learn.
Where is Korag? Your giant king is a weakling and a coward. I challenge him to single combat.
You're not worthy to even speak his name. Run while you still have legs. Korag rules these mountains. He will unify all Jotun behind his iron fist.
If I need to kill you and every other Jotun here to get Korag's attention, so be it.
If you truly wish to be tested, the worship stone behind me is an ancient and holy relic. Its power judges any who touch it. Fail and die.
Touching a rock earns me the right to fight Korag?
Walk away while you can still mock death. Otherwise, we'll mock your smoldering corpse.
Tell Korag to prepare for battle. This won't take long.
Why is that Norn approaching the worship stone? And why are we allowing it? Because we could use some entertainment.
Not sure you entertainment.
You dare tread upon our sacred ground? Die! From the shadows of memory, I salute you.
Who are you?
I am the elder known as Thrawn. I was a giant king when the Jotun ruled all that we surveyed. My people were proud and strong. Now, I am but an echo of the past.
Your people are in great danger. Korag has begun to worship the Ice Dragon, a creature that will destroy them. The Ice Dragon has already brutalized my people. It will corrupt and consume the last of yours if Korag has his way. Help me stop him.
The blood of giant kings flows in Korag's veins and gives him great power. I cannot stop him, but I can tell you the tale of the giant kings. Perhaps that will help you save my people from this fate. I will show you the Jotun of ages past, when we strode over the world as mighty lords. Witness the savagery, greed, and vanity that ended our glorious rule. Once, we were as gods. Behold, at the height of our power, arrogance and jealousy led the Jotun to civil war. Our blood is the blood of the mountains. In it, there is power. And so we fought over blood itself.
Fraxes. I shall feast on your beating heart. I am king, and this land is mine.
You're a pretender, Bokar. Not a king, not a brother. I'll burn this land before I yield it to you. The giant kings turned on each other. Brother murdered brother. Son murdered father. What we did not realize is that with each death, we weakened the very blood we sought to claim. We tore ourselves to ribbons, scrabbling over power. Now, we bicker over mere scraps. If Korag sacrifices his people to the Ice Dragon in his lust for power, our fall will be complete, and the Jotun will be no more. All that will remain is empty markings on snow-covered stone. Nothing happened. No flash. No fire.
No, I felt the stone's power. Something happened. We just didn't see it.
That's awesome. And just for anyone who doesn't know, it's they have a lot of similarities with the Norn, because the Sons of Svanir are Norn, and they were corrupted by the dragon, and they have their own civil war, so I'm fighting my own people. Which is sad.
Arrogant insect! You dare challenge me! You are nothing.
And you are nothing compared to what your people once were. Throne showed me the truth. Your lust for power will destroy your people, as it did in the old days. I came to challenge you, but for Elder Throne's sake, I'm giving you this chance. Reject the dragon. Your people have already suffered enough.
Pity from a Norn. I expected more. Jormag will give us the strength to restore our glory. We will rule the mountains again.
The Ice Dragon makes slaves, not kings. Ask the Sons of Svanir where their glory is, and you'll see that you've been lied to.
I will go and demand Jormag's blessing. When I return, I will show you the power of my faith. I challenge you to do the same.
Done. But I warn you, be wise as well as strong, Korag. If you insist on serving the Ice Dragon, I will cut you down.
Go acquire more power if you can. Until then, the mountain does not acknowledge the insect. Be gone. I'll be back. Especially if you call me an insect.
Spirit Fly, I'm Jormag. Raven's my favorite, but I like Bear too. Oh, but Snow Leopard is so sweet.
The journey continues.
It's worse than we thought. The Sons of Svanir have duped Korag. He thinks the Ice Dragon will make him a true giant king. I offered him a way out for his people's sake. He's gone to get the truth from the Sons of Svanir. Either he'll defy them, or they'll have to prove the dragon's strength and make him even more powerful.
Jotun, don't walk away from a challenge. The Sons will make Korag 10 times more powerful, and he'll fight. You'll be no match for him, even with Eir's help.
Bygarth is right. You'll have to prepare. Wolf favors those who stand for the pack, as you have. Speak with Wolf Shaman in Holbrek, and Wolf will aid us.
I prefer something more solid. You need a worthy weapon to crush Korag. With a bit more effort, I can make the Deldramore weapon we started mighty enough to topple a giant king. It will require tempering in the heart's blood of a mighty beast. There's a griffin named Windshear. If you can track him and defeat him, the weapon will be unmatched.
Very well, Slayer. Choose carefully. This is part of your education in becoming a great hero. Do you want to secure Wolf's blessing, or enhance Bygarth's weapon?
Well, that's a good one. I don't know, actually. Get a mighty weapon. Or be blessed by the wolf from the mist. Well, you know what? I'll go with the blessing. Would die. Rusty die is mine. Oh, I actually did have an upgrade in there. the rest is going to have to wait. I'll be back tomorrow. See you guys then.